Hey, I'm Theresa, and in this video I will show you how to connect the status indication light and the flow switch of the FlowFit CYA27 assembly to Liquiline CM44 transmitter. So this is a pre-configured CYA27 assembly. It has a disinfection module, a pH module, and a flow module. And the status indication light and the flow switch are available as pre-mounted accessories or as an upgrade kit. The flow switch is used to monitor a continuous adequate level of flow through the assembly, which is essential for correct measuring of the disinfection component. And the status indication light shows if everything's fine with the measuring point or if there are malfunctions detected by the transmitter. For installation, the following components are required and not included in the delivery. The DIO module for the Liquiline transmitter CM44, 3 connecting cables, approximately 20 centimeters. They will be added soon to the scope of the delivery, but not so far. Ferrules, a cable stripper, and screwdrivers. So when the flow switch and the status indication light come pre-mounted, then all you have to do is install the wall mounting kit and click the assembly in the securing clips. Then install the sensors, connect them, connect the electrical components, connect the assembly to the process, and then wire the electrical components inside the transmitter and manage the settings. So before you start with the wiring inside the transmitter, make sure that the device is unplugged and that there's no voltage on any cable. And assure that you're working according to the ESD guidelines. The flow switch and the status indication light need to be connected to the Liquiline with the DIO module and the alarm relay. I already prepared the cables. I removed the orange outer cable shielding and guided the cables through the bottom of the Liquiline. And I also applied the ferrules at the end of the cables. Now wire the cables according to the wiring diagram in the operating manual. I start with the cable of the status light. The blue cable is connected to the power supply of the DIO module. The brown and the black cable are connected to the alarm relay. Then I need the connection cable from the alarm relay to the power supply. I go ahead with the cable of the flow switch. Here I start with the blue one in the cable clamp. And from that cable clamp, I have 2 connection cables, one to the digital input, and the second one to the supply. Then I go along with the flow switch cable with the black one that goes in the digital input, and the brown one to the power supply. A detailed illustrated instruction can be found in chapter 5 of your operating manual. Now plug in and power up the LiquiLine transmitter. First, activate the binary input of the flow switch. Therefore, go to Menu, Setup, Inputs, Binary Input, and enable the binary input. The signal tip is a static signal and signal level is low. Then assign a limit contactor to the binary input in Menu, Setup, Basic Setup, Limit Switches, Limit Switch 1, and select the options Binary Input as Source of Data, Function On, and Operating Mode above Limit Check. Now the relay for the status indication light needs to be activated. When using the alarm relay, please check if the alarm relay has already been activated. In Menu, Setup, Basic Setup, Alarm Relay, its function needs to be turned on. It is a diagnostic function with operating mode Namur F. So when using the alarm relay, it's no longer available for other messages. And if you're using, for example, the 2R or 4R module, the settings differ, and therefore please find the respective settings in the operating manual of your CYA27 assembly. To assign the flow switch for the status indication light, reconfigure the diagnostic message for the limit contactor S910 in the Menu, Setup, Basic Setup, Diagnostic Settings, Diagnostic Behavior, then down to S910 limit switches, so needs to be on, and the status signal needs to be a failure F. As soon as the flow rate is insufficient, F910 limit switches is displayed on the device, along with a red screen and the red status indication light on the assembly. So any other error that is detected by the transmitter and results in a red screen is also displayed on the assembly. So not only due to the flow, but also to the sensor connection, for example. So now everything is set up. Before you leave the measuring point, please make a function check. Does the light shine green when everything's okay? Yes, it does. And does it turn red when you shut down the flow? It does. Does it turn green again? Perfect. And what happens when you disconnect the sensor? Perfect. So everything's configured correctly. That was my video tutorial how to connect the status indication light and the flow switch of the CYA27 assembly to the LiquiLine transmitter. I hope this video was helpful, and if you like it, heart it!